The second wave isn't just starting, it's already underway. By staying home, people are wearing masks. That's critical, so keep it up. Emergency wage subsidy, people still need this program, so we're extending it right through to next summer. Protecting people's health, supporting Canadians, building back better. Maybe you were one of the almost 9 million people who used the Canada Emergency Response Benefit this spring. We can build a stronger future. We are Canadians, and together, there's nothing we can't do. My fellow Canadians, good evening. In the West, good afternoon. I want to speak directly to you today because Canada is at a crossroads. Je sais que la lutte contre la COVID-19 a été difficile pour tous les Canadiens durant les 6 derniers mois. Pour trop de gens, c'est une question de vie ou de mort.
It's a question of life and death.
Et pour nous tous, collectivement,
and for all of us, collectively,
c'est le combat de notre génération.
It's the fight of our generation.
Au printemps, on
in
a tous travaillé ensemble pour aplatir la courbe
together
et nos efforts ont porté fruit.
To flatten the curve. And our efforts have borne fruit.
Le virus est en train
Now,
de revenir en force
the virus
dans
is coming back in
pays.
Force in many areas of the
in
country.
In our four biggest provinces, the second wave isn't just starting. It's already underway. The numbers are clear. Back on March 13th, when we went into lockdown, there were 47 new cases of COVID-19. Yesterday alone, we had well over 1,000. We're on the brink of a fall that could be much worse than the spring. I know this isn't the news that any of us wanted to hear. And we can't change today's numbers or even tomorrow's. Those were already decided by what we did or didn't do 2 weeks ago. But what we can change is where we are in October and into the winter. It's all too likely we won't be gathering for Thanksgiving, but we still have a shot at Christmas. Together, we have the power to get this second wave under control. I know we can do it because we've already done it once before. In the spring, we all did our part by staying home. And this fall, we have even more tools in the toolbox. People are wearing masks. That's critical. So keep it up. We've got the COVID Alert app. Take the teacher who felt fine, but who tested positive after the app warned her she'd been exposed. COVID Alert meant she went home instead of the classroom. It's a powerful, free tool that's easy to use and protects your privacy. So if you haven't already, download it off the App Store or Google Play. It's one more way to keep ourselves and others safe. Another is to get your flu shot this fall. Les gestes qu'on pose aujourd'hui vont faire toute
Our
la
gestures
différence
today
sur ce qui
will make
dans
all
deux
the difference
et dans deux mois.
In 2 weeks.
Porter un masque,
wearing
ça
a mask saves lives.
Vos mains,
washing hands,
distance,
keeping your distances,
contre la grippe,
getting the flu shot,
les agences de santé publique,
listening to public health advice,
limiter votre cercle social,
limiting your social circle,
prendre des risques qui
avoiding
sont pas nécessaires.
Unnecessary risks.
C'est pas le temps de faire des parties.
Now,
personne
time to have parties.
Et
no one is invincible.
Ne le sont pas non plus.
And family isn't either.
On peut pas baisser nos gardes, même
we
dans
can't
les
let
où
our
le nombre
guard
de cas
down.
Est encore bas.
Even places where the number of cases
plaît,
is still low. Please, everybody, download the COVID Alert app.
Gratuite,
it's
elle
easy,
votre vie privée,
free,
et c'est
it
un
preserves your privacy,
vous,
and this will protect you and protect
vous.
Those around you.
This is the time for all of us, as Canadians, to do our part for our country, as government does its part for you. There is a covenant between government and the people government serves. You need to know that you can rely on us, just like you can rely on each other. Alors qu'on fait face à cette crise, alors
we're facing this crisis,
à rebâtir,
as
on va continuer d'être là
we're about
pour
to start rebuilding, will be there for you. The government set out a four-pillar plan to meet the crisis. The first thing we must do is to protect the health of people. What our parents, what our grandparents did, the generation that faced the Great Depression and the Great War, remind us that we must be resilient and patient in time of crisis. They built the world of today, and it's up to us now to build the world of tomorrow, starting by protecting them. The situation that too many of our elders have experienced in long-term care homes is unacceptable. It has to change, and it will change. In the spring, we sent the Canadian forces to help. The Red Cross is still on the ground. We're going to be working, starting now, with the provinces and territories to set new standards, national standards for long-term care.
Job one is keeping people safe. That's why we're signing deals on multiple potential vaccines, on therapeutics, on personal protective equipment. In fact, because we mobilized this spring, Canadians are now producing almost every type of PPE we need. We're helping the provinces and territories ramp up their capacity on testing while creating a federal response team for surge demand. And as soon as there's approval for faster tests to be used safely, we'll get them out across the country. If you need a test, you should be able to get one and get it quickly. This is about safety. And it's about what's right for Canadians. Protecting your health is the best thing we can do for the economy. So that's what we're working on first. And that brings me to the second part of the plan, supporting Canadians through this pandemic. The federal government will have your back, whatever it takes, to help you get through this crisis. Maybe you were one of the almost 9 million people who used the Canada Emergency Response Benefit this spring. We will continue to support all those who need it with a strengthened and broadened employment insurance system. Maybe your boss was able to keep you on the job or hire you back because the emergency wage subsidy helped with the payroll. People still need this program, so we're extending it right through to next summer. Or perhaps you're a business owner needing extra help to bridge to better times. For you, among other measures, we're expanding the Canada Emergency Business Account. And there's a lot more we're going to do. Go to canada.ca/coronavirus to see what support is available right now and how to apply. I know some people are asking how we can afford to do all this for Canadians. That's fair. Low interest rates mean we can afford it. And in fact, doing less would end up costing far more. Doing less would mean a slower recovery and bigger deficits in the long run. While we're dealing with this pandemic, I don't want you or your parent or your friend to take on debt that your government can better shoulder. So yes, in the short term, we'll keep investing. But beyond the emergency, as we start to build back better, we must do that in a fiscally and sustainable way. Investing for our recovery must be done responsibly. Vous savez, la pandémie dévoile des inégalités.
The pandemic has unveiled fundamental inequalities in our society, but now we have an opportunity to act to change it. We're going to build a better society for everyone, and at the same time make the economy better for all. In fact, this is the third pillar of the government's approach.
By creating a Canada-wide early learning and childcare system, we'll ensure that kids have access to care and that no parent, especially no mother, has to put their career on hold. This pandemic has reminded us all that building strong social supports is essential to growing the economy. By accelerating progress on national universal pharmacare, we'll get people the medicine they need while alleviating pressure on the healthcare system. En investissant pour éliminer
By investing to eliminate chronic homelessness, we'll create healthy and prosperous communities. Housing isn't just a problem, it's also a solution. Housing creates jobs. Housing allows people to contribute. We all want to build a stronger country for everyone. And to that end, we have to redouble our efforts to fight against climate change. And that is also the best way to create good jobs for tomorrow and for today.
Energy workers innovating to decarbonize. Auto workers building zero-emission vehicles. Engineers and construction workers delivering green retrofits for our homes and buildings. These are some of the people who will create a competitive economy of the future. As we do this work, protecting people's health, supporting Canadians, building back better, we can't forget what it's all for. Making sure that everyone can participate to their full potential. And that's the final part of the plan. As a country, we must keep making progress on reconciliation with Indigenous peoples and on fighting systemic racism. Diversity is not just our strength, it's our competitive edge. Nos différences nous enrichissent.
Our differences make us richer, whatever the color of our skin, our beliefs, our culture, our language. In our country, we're proud to have two official languages, French and English, that we will continue protecting. In Canada, we know that we are stronger when we are united and when we help each other. We meet challenges together. That's what has helped us manage the crisis better than many other countries.
This is not the first time our country has been called to stand united and strong. In the face of change, our greatest generation showed us that overcoming crisis isn't easy. They didn't give up, and neither can we. To parents feeling like you can't get your life under control, to kids wondering why mom and dad can't just fix this, to seniors feeling like there's nothing you can do and thinking about all the things you can't do, that's understandable. But can't will not define us. We can bend the curve. We can build a stronger future. We can define the change. Les Canadiens,
Canadians on est des gens qui disent, are people who say, we can.
Secteur,
we can do it in each industry, in each region, in every area of the country. Each of us is doing our part. The story of this pandemic is the story of people making sacrifices, people working hard every day to be there for each other. And above all, it's the story of our frontline workers, the heroes from coast to coast who never hesitated, never flinched in this fight. You are a source of inspiration for all of us. We're at a crossroads, and the future is in our hands.
There are many days to go before we get to the other side of this. But there are also many of us to get us there, so long as we each remember to do our part. And I know that we will. We are Canadians, and together, there's nothing we can't do. Prenez soin de vous, mes amis. Merci.